It's been a rocky road for the self-driving car market as Uber's pedestrian death debacle has every company screeching to a halt. Can I fit another car pun in there? Just one? One more? Yes? Wait. I got it. Wait. Don't. Autonomous cars are cool, except when they decide a person isn't enough of an obstacle to swerve around. Well, that's oversimplifying it, but you get the gist. After investigation, Uber found that the modified Volvo test car that killed 49-year-old Elaine Herzberg in March actually did, quote, see her and recognize her. However, the problem occurred when a bug in the software actually made it so that the car didn't have to take evasive action, which on a technical level unfortunately makes sense. Computers and everything we put them in, including cars, have to determine if every obstacle calls for evasive action. Not all do. In this case, though, since the threshold for an obstacle was set so low, the car continued its course through the obstacle, even though that obstacle was a human. Even more tragic, the human in the autonomous car, who was designed to be a safety if the car malfunctioned, was looking away from the road at the moment of impact. Talk about bad luck. And while this has led to Uber suspending all of their self-driving car tests pending investigation, that didn't stop other startups from taking on the Goliath of a challenge themselves. Drive.AI has begun testing its little blue and orange taxis just outside Dallas, where they hope they will launch a full fleet in July to drive a set route with backup drivers capped at 45 miles an hour for 10,000 locals in the area. Considering this is the first instance of a self-driving car since Elaine Herzberg died, it's a considerable step forward in a field plagued with skepticism and government red tape. In fact, the venture capital market seems to continue to have faith in the future of the technology, as Drive.AI has already amassed over $77 million in funding, but its 100 employees are taking it one baby step at a time. Drive.AI is starting in the small city of Frisco for very clear reasons. The streets are wide, the streets are clean, there are very few pedestrians, and the sun is out over two-thirds of the year. Plus, it doesn't really hurt that a new Texas law lets self-driving car companies run without local law restrictions. Regardless of what the space looks like now, Drive.AI has some major ambitions, including removing their backup drivers from the car by the end of the year. They've even distinguished themselves from the competition because of the way their cars communicate with people by displaying messages like waiting for you to cross or picking up. And in case of communication failures, or if the cars are uncertain of how to respond to a new situation, they can even phone a friend, literally. Technical support is an internet call away, and technicians can send help to the cars that call from their three separate cell networks. In cities that grow as quickly as a million people a decade, investing in new technology to improve city efficiency seems to be the smart move for the future. We'll be right back.